Hello, we continue the series Verge3D for Maya Basics. In this part of the tutorial, we'll add the post-processing effect Bloom and set up anti-aliasing. Before doing this, let's go to Verge3D export settings in Maya and make sure that we have the Use HDR rendering checkbox enabled. Now run the puzzles editor. We are going to enable the bloom effect. To do this, go to post-processing and drag out the corresponding puzzle. The blue icon on this puzzle means that its parameters can be tweaked in real time, and the results will be displayed in the viewport. We can use these sliders to quickly set up for our effect. So let's do it. Click Run to enable this puzzle. We can see that the reflective parts of our model obtained some additional brightness and blurriness. So this is already good enough. But we can tweak it a bit. Let's increase the threshold. This parameter denotes the level of brightness after reaching which the bloom effect is applied. Let's make it 1.5. The next parameter, strength, is self-explanatory. Let's leave it as is. Lastly, we have the radius for blurriness. Let's make it a bit bigger. Let's save and check it out in the app. So we can see that this effect works, making our model much more engaging. Especially this effect is noticeable on the blades of a knife. So now let's make the rendering even more realistically looking by setting up anti-aliasing for it. Supersampling anti-aliasing that we're gonna use is a very expensive technique, so it should be enabled for static scenes. For this purpose, we'll use the puzzle called Disable Rendering that also have the anti-alias checkbox on it. So if we run this scenario now, we can see that the rendering has become sharper. However, the scene is no longer interactive. If we enable rendering, we can restore the interactivity, but anti-aliasing is gone. Aliasing, which we'd like to get rid of, is noticeable on the logo, as well as on the edges of the blades. So let's implement a scenario in which the rendering is disabled only when the user is inactive and nothing is happening on the scene. So we have a few moments when we want the rendering to be on. This is when the user moves the camera, when animation is playing back and the materials are swapped. So let's set up our scenario in such a manner that the anti-aliasing is only enabled when the scene is static. First of all, let's detect when the camera is moving. This can be implemented with the event puzzle called When Moved. This puzzle tracks the movement of an object and triggers the slots when the movement is started, is going on or stopped. We'll be tracking the movement of the camera, so let's the puzzle called Active Camera. We could also use an object selector and select the camera in it. But this puzzle is preferred if you have multiple cameras in your scene. So when the camera is moving, the rendering should be enabled. The rendering should be disabled when the camera no longer moves. Also, we want the rendering to be off initially. Let's save the scenario and check it out. Once started, the camera is not moving and the anti-aliasing is applied. Once the camera started to move, the rendering is enabled and there is no longer anti-aliasing. This is it with the camera. Now we also need to enable rendering during animation and for swapping the materials. But before doing this, let's reorganize our puzzles a bit. Let's create a variable that we call camera moving. This variable should be set to true when the camera starts moving. Once the camera stops, the variable should be switched to false. We'll be checking this variable every frame in order to enable or disable the rendering at right moments. So, if this variable is true, we should enable the rendering. Otherwise, the rendering can be disabled and anti-aliasing can be applied. Let's save and refresh the app to check that we didn't break anything. We see that anti-aliasing is applied upon start and turned off when the camera begins moving. If we stop the camera, the anti-aliasing is applied again, which is noticeable on the logo. So now we are ready to handle the animation, which won't work at the moment. During animation, the rendering should be allowed so that the user can see it. Let's add another variable, which we name animationPlaying. This variable should be set to true at the moment when the animation starts playing. Once the animation is stopped, the variable should be switched to false. So let's add it inside the whenFinish slot. Let's do the same with the folding animation as well. Now we can track this variable every frame. Let's set another comparison puzzle and switch its logic operator to OR. This means that if either of these two variables are set to true, the rendering should be allowed. Let's check it out. Now both the camera movement and animation disable the anti-aliasing feature. Everything works fine. The only thing left is to handle the material configurator, which won't work at the moment. let's create another variable, which we name material changing. This variable should be set to true once the user clicks on any of the swatches. We don't know exactly how much time it takes to swap a material, so let's add a timer with some small time value. So after a material is swapped, this variable should be switched to false, meaning that the rendering can now be safely stopped. We should also add this variable to the comparison. Let's duplicate this group of puzzles, switch it to OR again, and select the material changing variable. Let's see how it works. It looks like our configurator is functional again. And we now have a nice anti-aliasing rendering when there is no user activity in this scene. This is it. Thanks for watching and see you in the next video.